Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for coming back. My name is Anne. Today's video I'll be showing you how to make this beautiful buttoned shirt. Let's get straight to the tutorial. So guys, we have the measurement to be across back 19 inches, chest circumference 45 inches, around sleeve 14 inches, the sleeve length is 10 inches, and then the full length of the shirt is 29 inches. So guys, I have my 2 yards of African point fabric. I also have my measuring tape, a pair of scissors, and then a piece of chalk. So let's get straight to the tutorial. So first of all, we are going to cut the back part of this shirt, and the back part of the shirt is supposed to be 2 inches longer than the front part of the shirt. So we are going to be cutting on the wrong side of the fabric. So considering the chest circumference, which is 45 inches, divided by 4 and then add some allowance to it to be able to fold it. So on fold, I folded 14 inches for the back part of the shirt. You can go less or more depending on the allowance that you want to leave. So guys, like I said earlier, the back part of the shirt should be 2 inches longer than that of the front part of the shirt. Now the full length of the shirt is 29 inches plus these 2 inches extra that we are adding to the back part, and then another 2 inches for the hem allowance. So in total, this will be 33 inches. So we added 4 inches to the back part of the shirt. So that's exactly what I'm going to mark and then cut it out. So guys, after cutting the back part of the shirt, we normally add yoke to the back part of the shirt. So that small yoke that is at the back of the shirt is what we are going to be cutting. So it should be in the same measurement as that of the back part of the shirt. So I mean, the weight should be 14 inches as well. But the length, I'll be marking 9 inches because this is an adult shirt. It can go less if you're sewing for a teenager or a younger person. So I'm marking 9 inches for the yoke for the back part of the shirt. So after cutting that of the yoke, I'm going to go ahead and then cut the front part of the shirt. Now remember that we have an overlap for the front part of the shirt, which will be putting the buttonholes and then the buttons on. So the front part of the shirt's width is quite bigger than that of the back part of the shirt. So the width for this is going to be 2 inches. This is going to be 2 inches wider than that of the back part of the shirt. So I'll be marking 16 inches for the front part of the shirt. Remember, the back part was 14 inches, so I added 2 inches to this. So I'll be marking 16 inches for the width of the front part of the shirt. The 2 inches will be for the buttons and then the buttonhole. You can make it less. You can make the 2 inches less if you want. Now for the length of the front part of the shirt, the full length is 29, so I'll just add 2 inches hemming allowance to it. Remember, the back part, we said it should be longer than the front part. That is why we had 4 inches extra allowances to it. So that's it. I marked the 31 inches, which is full length 29 plus the hemming allowance, which is 2 inches. So that's exactly what I marked. So I'm going to cut that out as well. So after cutting that off the front part of the shirt, I'll go ahead and then cut the sleeves for the shirt. Now, the sleeve for this shirt has its around sleeve to be 7 inches, to be 14 inches. So divided by 2 will be 7 inches. So I'll add extra inches allowance to it. So I'm cutting off for 9.5 inches. And then the full length of the sleeve is 10 inches. So I added extra inches to it, like 2 inches or 3 inches allowance or hemming allowance to the sleeve. So I'm going to cut the same length. I'm going to cut 2 pieces of what I cut earlier. So I'm just placing the first one that I cut on top of this to be able to cut the same thing. So this will be the sleeve for the shirt. So guys, I'll go ahead and then cut the collar and then the collar stand for the shirt. Now I'll cut on fold like this, 3 inches on fold like this. So guys, now the full length of the collar and then the collar stand will depend on the neckline measurement. So you could as well wait till you have your neckline measurement before you cut this out. But then I'm going to cut like 17 inches of this. I'm going to cut like 17 inches of this and then wait until I determine my neckline for the shirt before I conclude on the measurement that I'll be using for both this and then the collar stand. So I'll be cutting that of the collar stand later on in the tutorial. The length of that will be 1.5 inch for the collar stand. So let's go along with the tutorial and I'll show you how to cut the collar stand later on. So guys, if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, please consider clicking on the subscribe button, click on the notification bell, like this video, share this video, and then leave a comment on where you didn't understand. So this is the front part of the shirt. I'm going to divide it into two, or I'm going to cut it into two like this. I'm going to cut it into two. Now, mind you, the male shirt has its buttonholes at the right side of your fabric, and then the where we put the buttons on at the left side of your shirt. So what I'm ironing now is the left side, which is the one that is the part that is going to have my buttons on top. So I earlier folded in to a quarter of an inch and then folded in 1 inch like this. I earlier folded in to quarter and then folded in 1 inch. So after this, I'll stitch it all the way down. But before then, I'll apply my gum stay on the right side of the front part of the shirt like this. I'll apply like 1.5 inch gum stay on it like this, and then first of all I'll fold in like 1/2 inch like this and then flat iron it. I'll fold in 1/2 inch and then flat iron it. That is for the right part of the front part of the shirt. I'll fold in 1/2 inch like this and then fold in like 1.25 inch. Fold in like 1.25 inch like this. Fold in 1.25 inch like this. So this is what is going to be having my buttonholes. Now I apply the gum stay because of the buttonholes that we are going to be using. We are going to be having on the right side of my shirt. So I also stitch this one to all the way down, just as I'll be doing for the the left side. This is the right side and this is the left side. Let me take to the same machine and stitch this down. So guys, this is done. So this is how it will be looking like. So I have the right side. The right side will be overlapping. The right side will be like this. So I'm not going to be cutting off the necklines for this. So I place the right side down and then place the left side on top of it, like how you can see it, like this, leaving a gap, like half inch gap, like this. This is the right side and this is the left side. So the left side is on top of the right side, with the right side facing each other. After that, I will place the back part of the shirt on top of the left part, on top of the left part of the front part of the shirt. I hope I'm not confusing you though. If you get confused, just watch the video carefully and then you understand. I place the back part of the shirt on top of the left side of left part of the front part of the shirt. So this is the arrangement. Look at it carefully. This is the arrangement. The right side like this, the left with some space, and then the back part with like a quarter of an inch or a centimeter gap. Okay, so let's go to the neckline. So on the back part of the shirt, I marked 2.5 inches for the width of the neckline, and then the depth I marked 1.5 inch. That is for the back part of the shirt. I'll then curve it like this, and then measure 2 centimeters for the shoulder slant, and then join it to the neckline. I'll measure 2 centimeters down and then join it to the neckline like this. The shirt making is very simple. If you watch this video carefully, I bet you will make more of this. So I'm just going to cut this like this to be able to mark that of the front part of the shirt's neckline. I'll use my chalk to mark out the notched area and then use that measurement to calculate the 2.5 that I marked on the back part of the shirt. And then the depth of the front neckline will also be 2.5. The depth of the front neckline will also be 2.5, just as the width of it. And then I'll curve it like this. And then I'll curve it like this. I just marked it the 2.5 so that you will see this clearly. So I'll first go straight and then curve to cut out the neckline of the front part of the shirt, and then come to the back part and then trim off the neckline as well. After that, I'll go ahead and then trim off the shoulder slants. As you can see, I'll trim off the shoulder slants like so. So this is it for the neckline and then the shoulder slants. Okay guys, so after that, I'll pick the yoke for the back and then I'll flat iron it like this. And then I'll place the back part of the shirt on it to cut that of the neckline. I'll put the back part of the shirt on it like this, and then use it to cut the neckline for the yoke. So guys, now for the yoke, the down part, you can give it any shape that you want. You can make it rectangular like this. You can make it a triangular, any shape that you like. So for this, I'm going to be making it in the rectangular form. So I added my gum stick to it and then folded in like 1 inch and then flat ironed it. I want to make it rectangular, so I applied my hair stay or my gum stay to it and then flat ironed it like this before I attach it to the back part of the shirt. So I'll bring the back part of the shirt like this and then place with the right side, I'll place the wrong side of the yoke on it like this. So the right side of the back part of the shirt will be facing the wrong side of the yoke. So after placing the yoke on the back part of the shirt, pin it down and then top stitch or stitch this down to the end. So guys, this is how it looks like after you join the yoke to the back part of the shirt. This is how it looks like. So let's come to the front part of the shirt. I arrange them like this with the right side overlapping or on top of the left side of the shirt like this. Okay, so after arranging them like this, on the right side of the front parts of the shirts, after arranging them like this, I'm going to place the back part of the shirt with the right side of the back part of the shirt facing the right side of the front part of the shirt. I hope I'm making sense. You place the back part of the shirt on the front part of the shirt and then join the shoulders with half of an inch. So this is how it should come out after you join the shoulders. This is how it should come out after you join the shoulders. Remember, we added 2 inches. Remember, we added 2 inches to the back part of the shirt. So that will make the back part longer than the front part. So you have to pull the front part of your shirt to join it like this, so that drops the back part's shoulder slant like this. That would drop the shoulders of the back part to join the front like this. So this is how it should look like. Now I'll flat iron this and then top stitch the shoulders like so. Okay guys, so I turned this over. This is how it looks like after top stitching the shoulder joint. Now I'm going to be cutting the armhole for the shirt, but then I'm going to flat iron this to make it neat before I cut the armhole for this shirt. So guys, remember that I said the across back, which is the shoulder to shoulder measurement for this shirt, is 19 inches. Now the 19 inches, I'll add 1 inch allowance to it, so it'll be 20 inches. Now the excess that you have to divide it for both sides of your shoulders. But then the allowance was so many, was that much, so I have to trim off some of the allowances from both sides of the shirt. So guys, after trimming off some of the allowances on both sides of the shirt, I again measured my across back. So I had 20 inches and then I counted the excess. The excess was 5 inches. So divided by 2 will be 2.5. So that is exactly what I'll be using to cut the armhole. So I marked the 2.5 inches for the width, and then the length I'll be marking 8 inches for both sides. I'll go down by 8 inches for the length of the armhole or the depth of the armhole. I'll mark 8 inches for the depth of the armhole and then divide the excess of the across back, which is 5 inches, divide it by 2 and then share it for both sides of your shirt. So after getting this, after getting the length and then the width for the armhole, I'm going to be curving this. You go up like 2 inches. Go up like 2 inches on from the from the bottom or the down of the armhole and then curve it. So do same for the other side of your armhole and then cut this out. Okay guys, so if you haven't liked the video yet, please like this video, share this video, subscribe and then leave a comment on where did you understand. So as you can see, I just gave the shoulders some notches to be able to help me in fixing that of my sleeve. So talking about sleeve, you are going to be cutting that of our sleeve for the shirt. So let's go straight to it. So guys, this is our sleeve, so I'll open it like this and then fold in half of an inch and then flat iron it. I'll fold in half of an inch like this and then flat iron it. Remember, we added like 2 inches hemming allowance to it, so I folded in half of an inch and make sure my measurement is 10.5 because we'll be using the half inch to join the armhole on the shirt. So after folding in half, I folded in 1 inch like this and then flat ironed it. I'll do same for the other side of the sleeve as well. So after that, I'll take both to the sewing machine and then stitch it down like this. So guys, after stitching them down, I went ahead and then flat ironed them. So unfold like this. I'm going to be, first of all, the around sleeve is 14 inches, so that is divided by 2 will give me 7 inches. So that is exactly what I'm marking at the bottom of the sleeve. I'll go ahead and add extra 1.5 sewing allowance to this as well. But then for the curve on the sleeve, I'll be measuring that of the shirt armhole. The measurement of the armhole of the shirt to be able to get my armhole curve on the sleeve. So like I said, measure the armhole curve on the shirt to determine the armhole that you're going to be cutting on the sleeve. So I measured and I had 10 inches on both sides. I had 10 inches on both sides. So 10 inches was exactly what I'm going to be marking on the sleeve. So guys, like I said, my around sleeve is 14 inches, so that divided by 2 inches gives me 7 inches. So I added extra 1.5 seam allowance to it. Now this is how the armhole curve on the sleeve is going to look like. Okay guys, so I'm going to go ahead and come down by 3.5 inch like this, 3.5 inch like this, and then on the top of the sleeve I'm going to go in by 4 inches like this. So exactly the measurement I'm going to connect for the armhole curve. So this is how I'm going to mark the curve. It's like an S for the armhole curve. So I'll be measuring this to mark the 10 inches. So like this, I'll mark the 10 inches like so, and then join it to the 1.5 inch allowance that I marked. I'll mark the 10 inches and then join it to the 1.5 inch allowance that I marked. So this is how I'm going to cut the excess out. This is how I'm going to cut the excess out. Okay, so I'll use the one that I've cut to cut the other side of the sleeve. So guys, after cutting, I'm going to give this a notch, and then the notch will enable me to locate the center when placing it on the armhole on the shirt. So guys, this will be the part one of this video. I'll leave a link in the description box on the part two of this video. So stay tuned for the part two of this video. Subscribe, like this video, and share. Bye.